I want to show you another trick involving this freeze patterns. Let's call it lightning bolt. I do the same thing. I start with the row once. Now I prepare grid paper for myself. So it should be once here. Let me remind myself and everyone else the diamond rule. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I will choose some zigzag path from row ones at the top to row ones in the bottom. For example, this zigzag and put ones. I can choose any zigzag, but I need to put ones for the trick to work. So now I have enough information to start filling out this pattern using the compass rule. So for example, this spot wants to be filled out. 1 × 2 − 1 = 1. This spot, also 2. Now this spot, what should I put here? Do you want to help me?
That should be a 5.
I am correct. That should be 5. Here, 2. Here, let's see, 3. And here, again, 3. You see, so far, the miracle works. No contradictions, no negative numbers, no fractions. What should I put here? 3, I guess. Here, again, 3. What about here? Should be 5. 5 × 2 = 10 − 9. Yes, correct. What about this one? 2, I believe. Here, 2 as well. Here, 2. 1, 2, 3, it should be 6 periodic, so already almost there. So here, 1. And here, 1. And maybe to make sure, 1 here. You see what happened. I chose a zigzag path from top to bottom, filled out with ones, and filled out the pattern. Everything worked fine. So that's another miracle. It's called Haran phenomenon. What it really says, I will say something, of course, without real explanation. If I put X, Y, and Z here and start to fill out this table now using these variables and, of course, my compass rule, the formulas will be quite ugly. I don't want to do it. But Haran phenomenon states that I will always have a Haran polynomial. A Haran polynomial means a fraction which has just product in denominator. So if instead of these variables I put ones, I will have fractions with ones in denominator, which means integers. And that's why it works.
As this starting grid gets bigger, like 4 rows or 5 rows or 6 rows, can my lightning bolt be all sorts of different shapes?
Yes, absolutely. Any shape which goes always down, and each time you choose to turn right or left, any zigzag will work.
But again, my final population of numbers will result in one where the top row matches my triangulated polygon.
Exactly. Actually, it's a good point. So if we try hard together, we can figure out what kind of triangulation we get from this example. All right, so first of all, we need to figure out what is n-gon. Here, there are 3 non-trivial rows, so it should be 6 hexagon. I didn't prepare this, so I may fail. Yeah. 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1. Okay, so 1 is easy to do. That will be 1. The next one is 2. So I guess this. The next one should be 3, maybe like this. 1, 2, 3. Here we go. It works. Well, it should. It must. So I said that it was Coxeter who introduced it to contemporary mathematics, but as it happens, there were predecessors. And one of them was Carl Friedrich Gauss, as usual, as always. So Gauss had a paper which he called Pentagramma Mirificum. He did not publish it in his lifetime, but it was included in his collected work. And he studied a different problem, but essentially what he described in detail was a Frieze pattern of width 2. And if you look at this paper, you see the formulas which are now familiar to everyone.
So Gauss got there first, but...
Well, not the first time.
This side that's been cleaned.
Oh, you can see the line there. Okay.
The technique that I'm using is a gentle enzymatic treatment.
That's what I would have suggested.
Otherwise known as human spit.
All right.
And saliva is actually used in conservation all the time. It's a really gentle cleaning agent. It's 99% water, yeah. 1% enzymes, and it's the enzymes that break down the dirt, so.
Wow, you weren't joking.
Under the tongue.
Is this like a known technique?
Yeah, let's do a little section here.